Hello everyone, in this video we have one semicircle and this length is given 10, here is given 3, this angle is given 45 degrees, and here is given 90 degrees. The question is, what is the length of the x? Okay. First step, let's call here alpha, so here must be equal alpha plus 45 degrees, right? After that, if we connect these two points, if you focus on the triangle, notice that there's a diameter opposite side of the angle BAC, right? So angle BAC must be equal 90 degrees. Then if here's alpha, here must be equal 90 minus alpha, right? Therefore, alpha degrees left here, right? Okay. Next step, I want to represent this length with y. So, for this triangle, if we calculate tangent alpha plus 45 degrees, tangent alpha plus 45 degrees equal y over x, right? We know that the expansion of tangent alpha plus 45 degrees equal tangent alpha plus tangent 45 degrees over 1 minus tangent alpha times tangent 45 degrees equal y over x. If you focus on the triangle to calculate tangent alpha equal 3 over y, right? Therefore, if you plug in this value to the equation, three over y plus, we know that tangent 45 degrees equal 1 over 1 minus 3 over y equal y over x, right? If you equalize numerator and denominator, 3 plus y over y minus 3 over y equal y over x, right? These are again. So, 3 over y minus 3 equal y over x. Let's clear here. Therefore, x equal y times y minus 3 over y plus 3. Okay, this is the first equation. After that, if you focus on triangle BAC, for this triangle, if you apply Euclid's theorem, according to Euclid's theorem, y squared equal 3 times 10 plus x. So y squared equal 30 plus 3x. That means 3x equal y squared minus 30. So x is going to be y squared minus 30 over 3, right? This is the second equation. Let's clear here. Notice that these two equations are equal to each other, right? So if we equalize these two equations, y squared minus 30 over 3 equal y squared minus 3y over y plus 3. After the cross multiplication, y cubed plus 3y squared minus 30y minus 90 equal 3y squared minus 9y. So if you simplify the expression, these are again y cubed minus 21y minus 90 equal 0. So we get a cubic equation. Let's clear here. If we add minus 15y to both sides of the equation, you'll understand why in a moment. So y cubed minus 36y plus 15y minus 90 equals 0, right? Okay. If you put these two terms in parentheses with y, so y times in parentheses y squared minus 6 squared minus 15 times in parentheses y minus 6 equals 0, right? This time, if I put y minus 6 in parentheses times y plus 6 plus 15 equals 0. Okay? So y minus 6 times y squared plus 6y plus 15 equals 0. Note that for this equation, delta is less than 0, so there are no real roots, right? Therefore, y is going to be 6 units. Okay. Let's write here, y equals 6. Then, for triangle ABC, if you apply your theorem, we get the value of x, right? So 6 squared equal 3 times 10 plus x. Let's simplify. Therefore, x is going to be 2 units. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.